everybody. My name is Becky Ferris, and this is my audition video for the next Pilates Anytime Instructor Competition for 2018. We are inside this absolutely gorgeous space where my Pilates studio is located, called the Body Initiative in Lafayette, Louisiana. And this is my good friend and long-term client, Lauren, and she's here to help me make magic on the reformer.
Hi, everybody.
Okay, so all applicants were given the stomach massage to teach. So what we'll do is go through the series super slow as if you would be a beginner. That way we can create shapes and make references with our bodies. Then we'll move quicker as if it would be a more intermediate type style of class. So Lauren, go ahead and sit on the carriage as close to the lip of the edge of the carriage that makes sense to your body. And then you're gonna allow your feet to come onto the foot bar in Pilates stance. And your hands are going to be on the lip of the carriage. Now let's go ahead and straighten our legs out with a long spine. I choose to teach the beginner round back with straight legs. That way we can make our shape without contending with our hips. So Lauren, go ahead and flex your whole spine and think of your ribs being behind your pelvis and your shoulders being on top of your pelvis and your head being in front of those points. Now, I want you to imagine that there's this big deflated balloon around your whole person. Now, think of your body as being the breath that's gonna inflate the balloon. Oh, gorgeous. So not only is she gonna make the balloon wide, she's also gonna make the balloon tall. From here, she's gonna start flexing from her hips, and I challenge her to keep her ribs off of her thigh bones. Then when she straightens her legs out, she's going to make the balloon even bigger. Keep the shape as her heels sink under, and then lift. Try it again. Thighs and ribs stay pulling away. Balloon gets bigger. Balloon stays in that shape. Gorgeous. Good. Now, from here, go ahead and straighten the legs out, and we're going to transition into flat back. So her hands are going to go back behind her, and you can already see that her posture has changed to more of a lengthened spine. She's gonna go ahead and start doing the same choreography with her legs as round back. Now, I want you to think of your body now being like a tree. So the roots of the tree ground down into the earth, and the branches and the leaves reach up into the sunlight. So that's the same thing that she's doing with her body right now. The pelvis is grounding down into the carriage. The top of the head is reaching up towards the ceiling, and the leaves and branches are kind of sprouting out everywhere. That's going to help with a couple of things, her axial length and her sense of tensegrity through the series. Good. Now go ahead and stay in. For me, drop a spring. So take your hands on the inside of your knees and take it off. And go ahead and stretch back out. Okay, so now we're going to keep the same posture, but take the hands up and forward for reach. So now you can start bending and straightening the knees. Now what's happening is she's having to rely on herself to find this posture. She doesn't have the hands as kickstands anymore. So she's doing a little bit more work here to keep our nice long spine. And we're still creating that tree reference. All right, now she's gonna transition into twist. Now let's kind of break apart the spinal rotation. So think of your pants and your feet being a water bottle, and from above that, the cap of the water bottle. So start rotating to the left and imagine that you have to spin the cap to open the water. Now you can see that if the bottle and the cap go in the same direction, there ain't no way you're getting water out of that bottle. Good, last one. Now let's add the little knee bend with it. So fold in, and then as you twist, think of disassociating the bottom part of the body with the top part of the body. Gorgeous. All right, come all the way in. So I'm gonna set your springs back up for now the intermediate stomach massage series. And I want you to understand that our jobs as Pilates instructors is for you to get your client to be more self-efficient in her practice. So I would love for you to be able to do this work with or without me. Okay, I want you to take initiative of your own practice. So with that being said, do you have any questions about the things that we just did?
My one question is about breath. Moving into the intermediate level, when should I breathe?
Okay, so here's my answer to that. Breathing, as long as you're breathing, it's the right choice for me. Okay, so think of your breath as a tool, not necessarily a rule. So one way you can enhance that is if you want to make more spinal flexion, like in the round back, the place that you want to round more, use your exhale because that's going to help facilitate that round shape. And I'll just let you breathe and do whatever that means to you. And I will, if you need help, I'll give you some assistance there.
Okay.
All right, sounds good. All right, so she's going to do 6 of her own practice of the stomach massage series. Gorgeous, Lauren. So you can see as she's moving through her legs, she's constantly thinking of making that balloon shape bigger. And then she's also doing a great job of keeping that nice, stable spine and pelvis. She's going to transition into flat back. So the hands are going to go back into the shoulder blocks, and she's going to do the same leg choreography. And I like to kind of just go around, take a body scan as she's moving to make sure everything is where I would like it to be. And if it wouldn't be, not a big deal. We just kind of go from there. And another thing, as she's moving through the series, if she doesn't find stability 100%, you can keep moving. I just want her to know that it creates reference to the next time she does it. So no worries if it's not 100% stable on this exercise. Okay, she's going to drop a spring down and then reach. Good. Taking that tree analogy, putting it through her body and moving back and forth, staying nice and stable through the spine. Gorgeous. And her posture just looks pretty amazing here. Great student to have. Now you notice how when she does her twist, she's disassociating the bottom part of her body from the top part of her body. Gorgeous. And last one, nice, come all the way in. Place your hands on the bar and stretch out. Lauren, it was an absolute pleasure taking you through the stomach massage series, and I look forward to teaching you a class soon.